Hello, and welcome to this short video on finding and using subject terms in the Cumulative Index to Nursing and Allied Health Literature database, also known as CINAHL, at OHSU. For this to fully make sense, you'll need to have some working knowledge of Boolean operators and the differences between keywords and subject terms. The library has instructional videos on both topics, which you may want to watch first. Subject terms are an important part of database searching. While the medical database PubMed makes finding and using subject terms very easy, searching in CINAHL with subject terms takes a couple of extra steps. The first thing that you want to do is go to the library's homepage, scroll down to Quick Links, and click on the Databases tab to find CINAHL. Make sure you're logged in for full functionality. You will need to create an EBSCO account the first time that you do this. I usually search for keywords first and then find subject headings and use the OR operator to search for the keywords and subject terms together. You'll see why this is important at the end. For this example, I'll use heart attack as my keyword phrase, which returns almost 35,000 results. However, at this point, my search is still far from done. I want to make sure that I'm searching with subject headings as well. I'm going to show you three ways to use CINAHL to find subject headings. It's important to note that the subject system in CINAHL has been modified from the National Library of Medicine's Medical Subject Heading, or MeSH, system that you would use in PubMed. CINAHL's system is more narrowly focused on the fields of nursing and allied health. This means that you won't automatically be able to just use PubMed subjects in CINAHL. You'll have to find them yourself. To find the heading for heart attack, the first method is to click on the CINAHL Subject Headings tab. This takes you into the CINAHL Subject Heading system. Think of it as a dictionary that sits next to the database. Once you find the right subject term in the dictionary, you can bring it back over to the database. From here, I can go ahead and type in some keywords for my search concept. I can see that for heart attack, it wants me to use the subject heading myocardial infarction. I can also look at the scope note to make sure that the subject heading is correct. Go ahead and click on the subject. Here I can see where the subject lives within the hierarchical tree structure of the CINAHL subject heading system. Note that myocardial infarction has narrower terms nested underneath it. If I want to carry all the narrower terms with me back to the database, what I need to do is click on this explode box next to the term. This explode function happens automatically in PubMed. However, in CINAHL, I do need to do it manually if I want to include the narrower subjects in my search. This provides a little more control. You'll also notice that there are several subheadings I can include with my subject. By default, all subheadings are included automatically. If, for example, I was only looking for articles about education around myocardial infarctions, I would click on this box. However, usually at the beginning, I want to keep my search as broad as possible for each concept, so I'll just leave it as the full default option for now. Now, what I want to do is click Search Database. This is going to pull the subject heading from the dictionary back into CINAHL, where I can see that I've got almost 50,000 results. The second method for finding subjects is to enter my keyword phrase heart attacks into the search bar. This time, I'm going to click the Suggest Subject Terms box. Now when I search, instead of my keyword phrase, CINAHL will jump back over to the dictionary's subject terms. This takes me to the same place as clicking on the CINAHL Subject Headings button from the first method. From this point on, the second method is the same as the first one. I want to grab the term, in this case exploded, and search the database. The third method is a little bit different from the first two. In this method, I look at the results list from my initial keyword search, find a good-looking article, and click on the title. This takes me into the detailed view of the article. From here, I can see all of the subject headings that have been attached to this article. This is a good way to harvest subject headings at the article level and can sometimes be useful if I'm having a difficult time using one of the first two methods. You will notice that not every article in the database has subjects attached to them. This is another reason to search with both keywords and subject headings for a more thorough literature search. After I've done my searches, I want to go back to my search history, click on the subject search, and the keyword search, and then use the search with OR button. Note that I now have around 51,000 results, rather than the 34,000 from my keyword search. Searching with only keywords or with only subjects can potentially leave thousands of pertinent results undiscovered. We hope that you found this tutorial helpful in conducting more thorough searches in CINAHL. If you have any questions about anything we've covered in this tutorial, please contact the OHSU Library.